Hey, what's up guys, Neeraj here, back with another video. And today in this video I'm going to unbox a Redmi 4 and I will also review this phone. So let's get started. Let's start with the specification of this phone. It comes with Snapdragon 435 1.4 GHz octa-core processor along with 2, 3 or 4 GB of RAM, with an internal storage of 16, 32 or 64 GB. It has an 5-inch 720p display with 296 pixels per inches. This phone has an 13-megapixel rear-facing camera with f/2.0 aperture with PDAF support and HDR mode. And this camera is capable of recording a 1080p video at 30 frames per second. And it has an 5-megapixel front-facing camera with f/2.2 aperture. And the battery capacity of this phone is 4100 mAh. The 2GB RAM and 16GB ROM variant comes with a price of 7000, and the 3GB 32GB variant comes for 9000, and the 4GB and the 64GB variant comes for 11000 Indian rupees. Now friends, let's open this box and see how does this phone looks like. So here is the Redmi 4 itself. Let's take it out of the box. The phone itself is looking very nice. For now, let's keep it to the side and let's take a closer look at the other contents inside the box. So inside this box, we have a quick start guide and some safety instructions. We have a SIM ejector tool, a micro USB cable and a standard power brick. Now let's remove the plastic screen protector from the front and the back side of this phone and let's take a closer look at the device. So the phone itself is looking very nice. It has a very similar design like the Redmi Note 4. The only difference is that this phone is smaller than the Redmi Note 4. So friends, the unboxing is over now. Let's talk about the design of this phone. As I said, this phone is similar to the Redmi Note 4. It has a 5-inch display as compared to the 5.5-inch on the Redmi Note 4. The front side of this phone looks very great because of the 2.5D curved glass. The 2.5D curved glass joins the chassis of this phone very smoothly and it looks really very awesome. Moving on to the back side of this phone, the back of this phone is completely made up of metal and it feels very premium while you hold this one. According to me, this is a very minimal looking design. And the fingerprint sensor is also provided at the back of this phone, like the other Redmi phones. Xiaomi has done a very great job in designing this phone. Considering the budget of this phone, it is a really very good looking device. To the left side of this phone, we have a hybrid SIM card tray, and to the other side, we have a power key and the volume up and down buttons. And to the bottom of this phone, we have a micro USB port and the very precisely cut holes for the microphone and the speaker. Now let's talk about the display of this phone. It has a very attractive display. It has a 5-inch 720p display with an PPI of 296 pixels per inches. In the beginning, this display feels very attractive and colorful. You couldn't even tell that this is only a 720p display. The colors on this display feels very vivid and brighter. And this display has a 450 nits of brightness, which makes this display more better to be used in sunlight. The only drawback is that there is no protection to the glass of this screen, so you need to be very careful regarding the scratches and the accidental drops. And overall, this is a very good looking display at this price. Moving on to the software side of this phone, it comes with MIUI 8.2 based on Android 6.0 Marshmallow. The hardware and software combination of this phone is optimized very well, and Xiaomi is continuously improving the software performance of their devices. Now let's talk about the performance of this phone. This device performs very well. The Snapdragon 435 1.4 GHz octa-core processor gives this device enough power to run all the apps very easily and smoothly. This phone handles most of the multitasking very well without any performance issue. On the Geekbench 4, it scored 653 score and on the single core side and 2023 score on the multi-core side. This is such a big number for such a budget-oriented smartphone. and the fingerprint sensor of this phone is also really very fast. I have also tested the gaming performance of this phone, which is really very impressive. I have played Nova Legacy, Asphalt 8 and other similar games, and this phone handles all these games very smoothly, except some minor lags. Talking about the camera of this phone, it has a 13 megapixel rear facing 5 element lens with f2.0 aperture. It has PDAF support and HDR mode, and this camera is capable of recording 1080p video with 30 frames per second. This camera performs very well in the well lit conditions and begins to lose the image quality in the low lighting conditions, or you can say indoor lighting. And this phone has an 5 megapixel front facing camera with f2.2 aperture. Let's move on to the next thing, which is the battery life of this phone. It comes with 4100 mAh battery. This is such a big battery. It gives an backup of more than 1 day, which includes a lot of gameplay and YouTube videos. In simple words, I can say that this phone has a pretty decent battery backup. The only problem is that there is no fast charging support on this phone, and it takes a lot of time to charge this phone. It takes approximately 3 hours to fully charge this phone. Overall, this phone is one of the best budget-oriented smartphones. It had a very great looking display, great performance, great battery life, very attractive display. In my opinion, this is a complete package. So friends, that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you have enjoyed watching this one, and there is a lot of videos coming on my channel, so please subscribe to my channel. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in my next video.